Hi, this is James Cook of the University of Maine at Augusta, and I'm here in the woods today to talk about social research. It may seem like a strange place to talk about social research, but the thing about research is that once you get the basic mechanics of it, you can apply it to just about any setting. And so to talk about social research by analogy, I'll be talking about thinking about the woods and how you might use the language of research to describe the woods. One of the difficult things when you're getting started with research is distinguishing between setting, variables, units of analysis, and units of observation. And the four are connected, they're related, but they're really different. So one of the things I often hear from students, if they were to go out into the woods, would be to say, if I say, well, what's your variable? What's your dependent variable of interest? They might say, oh, well, my variable is the forest because it's what I'm interested in doing my research in. Well, that would be what we call the setting or the object of inquiry. The thing you're interested in understanding, the subject in which you want to carry out your research. That's setting, not a variable. A variable is different. Some other people, if I said, well, what's your variable? They might say, well, my variable is that tree, or maybe my variable is trees in general, if I want to study trees. But that's not actually a variable. Instead, if you want to study trees and you want to explain trees, that might be your unit of analysis. Maybe you want to explain variation between trees, but it has to be variation in something. A variable is a set of attributes for a characteristic, and it's a characteristic that varies. It's observable. We can see it or touch it or taste it or somehow otherwise measure it. And that characteristic has a variety of possible attributes. So for trees, we might take a look at trees and say, well, a tree isn't the variable. It's something about a tree that's a variable. Perhaps width of a trunk, right? You might have categorical variables, skinny, thick, or you might measure it in terms of inches or centimeters. But it would be width that would be your variable. Width is the thing you can observe that varies in its attribute, whether those are categories or numerical units like inches or centimeters. So what is the tree then? Well, in this case, the tree is the unit of analysis. It's the thing that we're trying to understand some characteristic about, right? Like width, which is a variable. The tree is the unit of analysis. And we might have an independent variable like width or a dependent variable like width. And which one it is depends on your theory. For instance, if we wanted to explain width, if we wanted to understand width of a tree as an outcome, we might think of that then as the dependent variable. And there should be an independent variable, which is something else, another characteristic about the same unit of analysis that would explain the width. Well, what could they be? Well, I can think of a few variables right now that might be independent variables. One might be age of tree, right? How many years old it is? How would we observe that? How would we operationalize that? Well, we could take a core, or maybe we could set up a camera like this one in the woods for years on end and watch trees grow, and we would have a date, and we could date the emergence of a tree and therefore its thickness. Maybe we could use the camera to measure the width automatically as well, that dependent variable. Another independent variable might be species. What kind of tree is this? What kind of tree is this? We might notice that some species of tree have different widths than others. And finally, I want to talk about how we would think about units of observation. as really distinct sometimes from the units of analysis. Usually units of analysis and units of observation are the same. So if we want to understand variation among trees, we might observe trees. But sometimes if we want to understand something else that is not directly observable, we have to observe something else. For instance, what if we were interested in understanding spacing of trees, right? Well, one way we might measure that is to go through the woods with a measuring tape and measure all the differences and distances in inches or feet between all the trees in the forest. The problem with that is that you have to combine all the different possible trees. And it turns out, right, that for every tree in the forest that you have that you want to measure distance to, you have to make a separate observation of distance for each tree, and then you go on to the next tree and you make another set of distance observations. Well, that would take you a very long time. It might be simpler for your unit of observation to be different than your unit of analysis. Even though you're interested in the distance between trees, you wouldn't observe distance directly in your observation. Instead, what you would observe is location. You might take out something like a GPS unit, and you might walk up to a tree, and you might observe the location of the tree. The tree itself would be the unit of observation. But then you would go back and you would, using the location of all the different trees in the woods, calculate something else, which is the relational distance between trees. And then you would be able to come up with a theory about why some trees are closer to each other and some trees are far from each other. I'm not a botanist, so I don't know how that would turn out, but I know that you could apply the same principles of research to trees, to plots of woods, to a whole forest that you could apply in understanding people.